Nice to have you with us.
CBS. And here again is Jane Pauley.
That's the legendary Julie Andrews and Victor Victoria back in 1982. All these years later, at age 88, she's neither lost track of where she came from nor where she's going. Mary Poppins was Julie Andrews' first film. Her second was The Sound of Music. If she had never made another movie, she might still be one of Hollywood's most endearing and beloved stars.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes.
And generation after generation would still be singing along.
Like winters that melt into springs, these are a few of my favorite things.
Though that was just the beginning of a career literally in its eighth decade, it's a very good place to start. Because now, Julie Andrews is a writer of children's books with co-author and daughter, Emma Walton-Hamilton. Their latest is a story of the theater from the perspective of a duck.
Mr. and Mrs. Puddlecock were expecting their first clutch of eggs.
Waiting in the Wings, your latest book, is a true story?
Yes.
Some years ago, here at Bay Street Theater in Sag Harbor, we happened to notice that a pair of ducks were nesting in a planter in our courtyard out front.
Soon, an altogether different sound filled the air. A pleasant, melodious one coming from inside the building.
We enjoy our ducks in the book. Theatrical ducks, very much so. They hear music.
Well, one of them is. Mr. Puddleduck, in our version of the story, sneaks into the theater. Waiting in the Wings is the 35th book by this prolific partnership. A collaboration that has given Julie Andrews a new voice. 30 years ago, a surgical procedure went horribly wrong, destroyed her famous soprano, and took her identity.
One day I was bemoaning my fate and missing very much the fact that I couldn't sing because the surgery went awry and took away my ability to do what I love to do. And so I was bemoaning my fate to Emma, and she said, "Oh, well, you've just found another way of sharing your voice." And I tell you, it hit me so hard what she said, and I've never really bemoaned it since.
Sounding a lot like a younger Julie Andrews.
When the Lord closes a door, somewhere he opens a window.
And there are some other intriguing parallels. Both Maria and Mary Poppins must win over stepchildren. They are all about fun, but not all about fun. They are sly teachers. They are optimists.
Yes, they are.
But they recognize that children have real problems.
You're absolutely right, and I think...
You and I talk down to... No, we don't talk down to kids. We don't. We try to bring them up so that you don't condescend in any way.
She's loved books since she was a child.
Waves of nothing waves.
Though born in 1935, her childhood memories include air raid sirens and running for cover during the Blitz, the German bombing of London during World War II. Her parents had already split up. It was her stepfather who discovered her voice. A 9-year-old soprano with an astonishing 4-octave range. And little Julie became part of her parents' musical act on the vaudeville circuit. Before long, she was supporting the family. You were paying the mortgage.
Yes, I was eventually, yes.
As a teenager,
Yes.
The family mortgage.
Well, we needed cash dreadfully. So eventually, when I was about 15, I went out on my own, all around England, around and around and around.
But with the responsibility that your family needed a roof over their head.
It was your job
to do it.
Well, I was part of the family trying to do it, but eventually it was just me, because my stepfather was an alcoholic, sadly.
So all that work and all that training, very serious training, you weren't reaching for the stars.
No, in fact, doubting that I ever would. I mean, I was doing it because it helped and I had to. In my teens, I would think, what is all this for? Where is it going to lead? And then suddenly the world broke open.
At 19, she was cast as the lead in a Broadway show. A 10-year veteran of the stage and a trained vocalist, but she was not quite ready.
I didn't have acting lessons or anything like that. I picked it up and learned, and people are very kind, and, you know, they don't hurt puppies, actually, if you know what I'm saying. And I was a puppy, and I didn't know what the heck I was doing, but I learned and was grateful for all of the teaching that I got.
Still a newcomer. At 20, she created the role of Eliza Doolittle, opposite veteran Rex Harrison in Lerner and Lowe's 1956 smash hit, My Fair Lady. The following year, she starred in a CBS production of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella on television. 100 million Americans saw Julie Andrews for the first time. In 1960, she was Guinevere to Richard Burton's King Arthur in Camelot. But when Walt Disney was in the audience one night, he saw his Mary Poppins.
Chim, chimini, chim, chimini, chim, chim, chirree. When you're with a sweet, you're in glad company.
It was an Academy Award winning performance.
Julie Andrews.
I know you Americans are famous for your hospitality, but this is really ridiculous.
She still radiates grace and gratitude, but in the very British tradition of getting on with things.
I just feel most of my life, and I've been so very, very fortunate to have the identity of a singing voice, to have the opportunities to learn about how to be on stage or film or whatever.
You were very fortunate, and you were also very unfortunate in some ways. Now, growing up in the war with alcoholic parents and being put to work at a very young age and being essentially robbed of a childhood.
Feeling needed and vital and valuable, too, yeah.
But her mantra has always been, are we lucky or what? That's what I think, whether or not it's true, it is the thing that got you through.
Perhaps I had a wicked child.
When Maria, in The Sound of Music, she's fallen in love and he's in love and it's the... And she sings a song that includes a line.
Somewhere in my youth and childhood. I must have done something good.
I must have done something.
Well, somebody must have, because I got so damn fortunate. Are we lucky?
Or what?
Yeah.
I'm the master reptile.